Well, hello and welcome to another series of The Israel Issue. In series one, we answered questions arising from God's irrevocable choice of Israel, through whom he continues to outwork his purposes. And in this second series, we're going to think about what difference that should make in the life of those of us who truly believe that we actually are grafted in to Israel. And that's why we chose the title, The Israel Issue, because the word issue can have two meanings. It can mean a question that really does need to be debated or discussed, but it can also mean that which flows out of or which issues forth from another source. And of course, that's what needs to happen for those of us who believe we are grafted into Israel. It's never been more true in the times in which we are living, that old saying which says, all it takes for evil to prevail is for good people to do nothing. And if those of us who understand that we are grafted into Israel do not in some sense demonstrate the difference it makes in our lives in practice by what we do or who we are, then we just remain in that group of good people who do nothing. And that is incredibly serious as a reflection on us understanding this most precious truth in these extraordinary times in which we live, when evil really is rising exactly as Yeshua said it would in the end times, saying in Matthew chapter 24, at that time many will turn away from the faith and will betray and hate each other, and many false prophets will appear and deceive many people. Because of the increase of wickedness, the love of most will grow cold. Now, at the moment, the church is doing a good job in providing a safe haven for believers, but it is not doing nearly such a good job at stemming the rise of evil in the world. And that's because very few believers have any understanding of how our relationship with God hinges on the promise that he gave directly to Israel. Because it was only to Israel that God promised the gifting and the enabling that they could be like lights in the midst of a dark world that would point people toward God. And that's why, without that relationship with God, we simply cannot stand out in the world like Jewish people do, let alone do so in the way that God wants us to, which we can only do by having a living relationship with the Jewish Messiah. And that's why we who are Gentiles need to very humbly remember the teaching of Jeremiah 31, which tells us that God only ever directly promised the new covenant to the houses of Judah and Israel. We can only then participate in the new covenant and receive the gifting that comes from it as we are grafted into Israel, which happens when we receive the Jewish Messiah Yeshua as our own Messiah and Savior, and that as we do so, he enables us to be grafted into what God promised and gave to Israel. And he is able to do this because he was and is and always will be the root and the offspring of David. And this means that when we receive Yeshua's presence into our lives, the one who is the root and the offspring of David, he enables us to draw from that gifting which God placed in the roots of Israel irrevocably, meaning that he cannot have removed it from there and put it somewhere else. And the flip side of this is that for those who then proudly think that in some way the church and they as believers have replaced Israel in God's purposes, that in some way they've become the new Israel, will never really be able to understand what Paul was really talking about when he said, "But you, being a wild olive, were grafted in and became a partaker of the root of the olive tree with its richness." And this is why today's church is as it is. It can be a safe haven for believers, but it doesn't have any great impact on the world because it lacks that gifting, which is only to be found in the roots of what God gave to Israel in their calling to be a light to the world. And without that picture of the gifting being there in the roots and us being like branches which are grafted into the tree that can draw up the nourishment or the sap which comes from those roots, there cannot be the fruitfulness that then impacts the world by looking so attractive and drawing the world to it as it offers another different vision of life and life in all its fullness. And that's why those of us who do have the grasp of that picture have both a particular privilege but also responsibility to demonstrate the fruitfulness that can come from it. Otherwise, how else will people ever learn about it? We have that privilege and that responsibility, and to fulfill it, we need to understand the very nature of that sap. We need to understand very specifically those seven different constituents of it which God led Paul to see and describe in Romans 9 to 11, which we can then draw on. We're going to introduce those in the next episode, and then in the episodes which follow, look at them one at a time. But right now, let's just focus on that picture of being the tree. The tree you can see described in Psalm 1, but also in Jeremiah chapter 17, where out of the gifting that comes from it, we may have a trust and a confidence in God that supersedes our circumstances, whatever they may be. We may be like a tree planted by the waters, spreading out its roots by a stream. It has no fear when the heat comes, but its leaves will be green. It does not worry in a year of drought, nor depart from yielding fruit. Isn't that the most brilliant picture of who we can be, whatever the circumstances of our future? Shining like lights in the midst of a darkness, and also issuing forth with a sort of fruitfulness that makes a difference in the world in which we will find ourselves living. If you'd like to think more about this, please do go to our website, www.lettheLionRoar.com. Go to the Israel Issue tab. There you'll find a short study which will enable you to dig more deeply into this. You'll also find previous episodes you might like to now refer back to. And if you're watching for the first time, do hit that subscribe button so that you will receive it direct in the future. Please do tell others all about it as well. And I look forward to being back with you in the near future with another episode of The Israel Issue. Audio Jungle.